Hello there. I'm just going for a little walk on my own. I've been out this morning already with the little doggies, but can't take them out twice. Mia, the older Padenko, Spanish Padenko, she only likes going out once. It's like try to take her out again, she gives you funny looks and runs away and hides. The little boy, he wouldn't come out with me anyway on his own. He's still very scared of me. He'll sit and lie next to me, sleep on me and everything. But as soon as you stand up, he's terrified, poor thing. You know, he's got a lot to get over. So anyway, I thought I would pop out for a little walk. It's a nice day. Got a bit cool breeze. You can actually see the Cheviots over there. That's the border between Scotland and England. You wouldn't pick it up on this camera, but I can see them. It's quite clear today. We've got a ship coming in. I'll just turn this around, have a look at them. So you've got a ship going into the harbour. There's Blyth Harbour over there. The ship going in. Very famous Blyth Harbour, you know. It had a submarine base. Based there during the war. Look, there's people swimming. I think that's like the surf school. Got them all swimming there. I think I'll stick with walking. I think I might go over the island over there. It's just a small island, man-made island, because it couldn't through for the shipping. I think 1700 or something like that. That's a nice level flat line. All the way along there, isn't it? Look, I'm gonna get a level, spirit level. I'm gonna measure it, see how much curvature's on there. Alright, let's turn this back. There we go. I'm up in the dunes. I'm gonna watch it all fall out on any rabbit holes, a lot of rabbit holes around here. You get a lot of hawks hanging around chasing. You get up in the dunes bit, you know, you get a lot of rabbits and hedgehogs and foxes. A lot of ferrets as well. The mice. We actually had a hawk in the in the garden yesterday. Actually caught a bird, unfortunately. But the thing is, I mean, the hawks have got to live as well, haven't they? So as horrible as it is, you know, it's nature, unfortunately, for the little bird. I think it looked like a starling, you know, and the hawk caught it. I think last year there was a hawk as well, don't know if it's the same one or not, and it caught a pigeon in the back garden, and I didn't know it was there, and I had walked out in the garden and it got its wings right up there and it was like staring at me. It was like, come and try and get this and I'll eat you as well. It looked a little bit evil, so I left it alone, but it made an awful mess. There was feathers everywhere and I had to go and clean them all up so the dogs wouldn't try and eat them. And then it is a very nice day today, but this one it was just basically only two or three feathers left yesterday. What a lovely day, a lovely day. We went right through the woods this morning with the dogs. And seeing the ducks there, it was quite a high tide. It's quite far out now. But so that when they get the high tide, the river is quite high as well. You know. And there's a plane coming over as well. EasyJet. Funny, like when you see them going over here, because the airport's not that far away from us. But there's no trail behind it. It's coming in there. It's a bit weird, isn't it, eh? So But yeah, we're seeing like there's a guy, he's got a Great Dane, massive Great Dane, huge Great Dane, and he sits and has a cup of tea or coffee, whatever, you know, like on the bench halfway through the woods, watching the river, and the ducks actually come up to him, you know, and they actually get like whatever he's giving them, I don't know, bread probably, you know, and he feeds them. And they actually sit right in, even in between the legs of this Great Dane. Looks hilarious. But yeah, these ducks there. I think there's seven. A couple of really small ones and the rest are all big. Look like the males, they're getting the colouring on. I don't know if it's the same ones I was keeping an eye on through the spring and summer. That maybe good old Henry was chasing down the river. Remember Henry? Did you see that video? I'm sure it was called Henry screaming and shouting, "Come here, Henry!" Chasing the ducks down the river. Anyway, I'm gonna walk over here. So I went live on Friday. We had a bit of a good chat. We were like doing like the Except for Value. Went over some basics for the Except for Value. I actually did it in the members area as well, but we did it much more in depth and had all of the paperwork, showed them all the paperwork, you know, the conditional acceptance, as well as the opportunity to cure and the affidavits, and everything, went over it and how to actually put it into the CEOs of whoever it is that you're paying with your AFV or promissory note. It's all a money order though, whichever one it is, and how to actually stand your ground. Because obviously what happens, a lot of people, they send in these either a promissory note or an accept for value, and then they turn around and they go, "Oh, but it didn't work, they didn't accept it." If you're on the Bills of Exchange Act, 1882, if you've actually supplied a money order, it's a source to pay, and you've supplied it, and they haven't returned it, and rebutted it, within 48 hours, it's accepted. Now, they can state and say anything that they want, but after that 48-hour period, it's accepted. Now, we have got quite a few people who it does work for, and it has worked for, and you've just got to make sure that you stand your ground. Now the whole idea, what I always say to everyone, if you can't stand your ground and you're not willing to do all of the paperwork and then send all of the paperwork out at the right time, and then also be prepared to go to court and fight your case with your evidence stack of your fiduciary appointment that you gave to the CEO, made him your fiduciary trustee, and then also having your actual copy of your note, and when it was sent through Royal Mail, when it was actually signed for as well, and then if it hasn't been rebutted, then it's been accepted. Just looking at the planes, nice and high up there, still no trails on them ones. A few yachts out there as well today, enjoying the autumn sunshine, huh? But yeah, remember, you've got to like be willing to stand there with your evidence. They say, "Well, look, this has all been accepted. You cannot tell me that it hasn't been paid for. You didn't return that." And then, you know, you've got to be willing to go to court. And if you're not, don't start the process, okay? If you can't finish it, don't start it. You know what I mean? So a lot of people panic when it's, "Oh, they haven't returned it, but you know, they haven't accepted it. They told me that I need to pay." Well, if you can't stand your ground and you're not willing to do all the paperwork and put the paperwork in and be prepared to go to court with it, then don't start the process, right? Just remember that. So I'm going to let's have a look. I wrote it down. I'm going to Bolton this month on the 22nd of October. I'll start sharing the video, the flyer out, you know. I'll attach it to some videos. I'll attach it to this one actually, for the people that are organising that one. I'm just going down there. I'm not, you know, I don't, you have to email them and arrange with them. But that's on the Bolden on the 22nd of October. I'll attach the flyer with their email and everything to this video. All right, if anyone wants to go along there. And then the next place I'm going to, on November the 12th, Saturday, November the 12th, I'm going to Norwich. And it's like a church hall, Methodist church hall somewhere down in Norwich that some people have arranged. So I'm gonna go down there. I will be doing a little link there to actually get the tickets. I'm gonna help them with the ticket sales, so I'll do that for them. So there'll be a link, and then we're actually going to be up here, not Newcastle, but we're going to go to Gateshead, which is just on the other side of the River Tyne, and that's on Saturday the 3rd of December. So one every month. It's quite busy, you know. It's a lot to try to cope with all of them, you know. It's quite a lot of work. But at least going to Gateshead, it's not going to take me long. It's only about half an hour drive to get to Gateshead on the other side of the river. Cross over the Tyne Bridge. Actually, I'll probably go on the bypass. I think it's easier to get there on the bypass rather than go through the city centre. But yeah, so those are the dates. The one for Norwich I will do a link for, and also the one for Gateshead I will do a link for. I'll put the flyer on here for going down to Bolton, because they're organising all of that. That's I was in Manchester, can't remember when, July I think, so it's the same people that organised that. Going to go down, so we're going to concentrate more on paperwork there, and I'll actually have like slides to go over. If you were at the Plymouth event, all right, we had a bit of a struggle getting the video off the phone and put like to get it.